The beast is down there.
No.
She knows the beast is down there. He's always
watching you.
She needs to find Ilya.
Where is it?
She found it. She lost it and she has to find it. The torch and light.
Go. Run away. behind you, would you?
The dragon Fafnir is so large and deadly that it would be impossible to kill him face to face. But each day, Fafnir crawls across the heath to find water. So Sigurd digs a pit in the dragon's path and lies in wait in it. When Fafnir slithers overhead, Sigurd sinks his sword into the dragon up to the hilt. Sigurd leaps from the pit, and Fafnir sees his killer. He warns Sigurd that the treasure will lead to his death, as it led to the death of all who owned it. Sigurd replies that death comes to all men, and every man would want to be wealthy until that day. And he takes the treasure.
The darkness will take her like it took her mother.
Deeper and deeper.
What's she doing?
She's lighting a torch.
She's making light.
She's making a fire.
She's got light on the outside.
So what's her plan? What's she thinking? How's she going to get there?
You killed her. You killed her.
Sigurd kills the dragon, Rian wants to keep Fafnir's gold all for himself. Rian also wants the strength and wisdom of the dragon, so he drinks its blood and asks Sigurd to roast Fafnir's heart for him. Sigurd does so, but when he touches the roasted heart to see if it is done, he burns his finger. Without thinking, he licks his finger and tastes the dragon's blood. In that moment, he understands the language of birds and hears them talk nearby.
Help but think of him. A tender guiding flame in a world so black. The longer it burned, the more she convinced herself that there was nothing beyond its reach. How little separates us from what we fear.
Sigurd's newfound power lets him hear the birds speak, and they say, Sigurd should have the heart himself. Rian wants Fafnir's gold. Sigurd should kill Rian before Rian kills him. Sigurd should find Brynhild the Valkyrie, who seems an enchanted sleep. Sigurd heeds the bird's advice. He kills Rian, eats Fafnir's roasted heart, and takes Fafnir's treasure. And he embarks on a new quest to ride to Hinderfell.
Come back. Do you hear me?
I hear you.
Come back to me, son.
I'm coming for you.
Follow my voice.
I'm coming.
Come back.
Just keep close your eyes.
Dillian, I see you.
The beast has Dillian.
No. leaving with him.
Turn your back on me. That is why Dillian was brought in now.
Oh.
People think of evil as an unnatural, invisible force, and so invoke the gods for protection. But evil can come from the hand behind the gods. A familiar hand, cold and cruel. He tried to fix her with his rituals, kept her trapped in that hole. She couldn't say which was worse. The darkness. Or the monster that her father had become. She couldn't fight them both. And so she left. Headed for the one ray of light that shone down on her. If she had stayed, she wouldn't have survived. Maybe Delian would still be alive.
I'm so sorry, my love.
She will save his soul. Even if this time she can't save her own.
Forgive me, Senua. I know you have no reason to trust me anymore.
Shut up. Listen.
But believe this. It was my mission to make you hate. To hate the darkness with a passion so great it would focus your mind on this quest. Without it, I fear you would have left those slack. All this time, I wanted to protect you from the truth that would have destroyed you a long time ago. But you have conquered your darkness at every turn. You deserve to see behind the veil of darkness.
And take me to the mountain to trust you, as deep as we can go.
I won't stand in your way.
She has to trust him.
You will not survive what is in there.
What else can she do?